Hello everyone, welcome back to Aspen Tech channel. So in today's video we will be discussing how to use performance curve in compressor while we are using Aspen HYSYS software. We have already done that part for Aspen Plus in our previous video. I will give its link in the description and in the pop-up of this video, and today we will be using the performance curve in Aspen HYSYS for the compressor module. So objective of this activity is to use performance curve to increase the pressure of vapor stream using compressor in Aspen HYSYS and recognize the way of using compressor in Aspen HYSYS. So we will be using the same problem statement and the same data which we have used for Aspen Plus. And what is that data? Data mixture which contains 50 weight percent pentane and 50 weight percent hexane is fed to the compressor at 200 degree centigrade and 1 bar at a mass flow rate of 30,000 kg per hour. So the conditions for the feed stream are fully specified, that we have been given the temperature, we have been given pressure, flow rate and mass composition. Calculate the duty and discharge pressure of the compressor if we have the compressor curve data. Operating shaft speed of the compressor is 7000 rpm revolutions per minute. So we have been given the compressor's operating speed. Obviously, the performance curve is given at some reference speed and to get the value of duty and discharge pressure. So what is the performance curve? Honeywell 210D1047 centrifugal compressor, and reference speed is 6177 rpm. The flow rate, which is in cubic meter per hour, the head, which is in meter, the efficiency, which is in percentage, is given for this compressor. And there are various set points which are available to us. Now we can either enter these set points manually in Aspen HYSYS, or we can take all this data to MS Excel and then we can simply do the copy pasting. So what I have done, I have taken all this data to MS Excel, and as you can see, the data is presented over here. The flow, head, efficiency and all the values are presented over here. So what we will do, we will go to the Aspen HYSYS, we will add the components, add the compressor after obviously specifying the property package, and then we will add this curve by simply control A, control C and placing here as control V and giving the speeds. Reference speed is 6177 rpm while the operating speed is 7000 rpm. So let's quickly go to Aspen HYSYS and solve this activity. So what we will do, we will first add the components. Pentane and hexane are given to us, and obviously we know that for a hydrocarbon system we have to select Bang-Robinson as the thermodynamic property package or the fluid package, as we can say in Aspen HYSYS language. So going to the simulation, and this compressor module is present over here, placing it over here and doing the required connections, like naming it as compressor, then inlet, then outlet, and finally providing the energy stream. So first we need to specify the feed conditions, and what are these feed conditions? The 200 degree centigrade, 1 bar, if you space 1 bar, 30,000 kg per hour, and double clicking on it to specify the mass fraction, which is 0.5 for pentane and 0.5 for hexane. So clicking on OK, and you can see the feed stream is completely specified and the color of this stream is changed from light blue to dark blue. Now we have to specify the curve, and if you remember in our previous video which was related to the pump performance curve, we will go to this rating tab. The efficiency curve is adiabatic efficiency, compressor speed is 7000 rpm, and what we need to do, we need to add curve over here. And now after adding the curve, we can name it as we would like, but again if it is named as curve, but no issue with it. Then the reference speed is 6177 rpm, the flow units is cubic meter per hour, and we have to change head units to meter. Now the volumetric flow, head and percentage efficiency. What we need to do, we need to go here, simply control A, control C, and placing it over here like control V, and you can see all the data is placed over here. Now before clicking on enable curve, you can go to this design and you can see in parameters currently 75% efficiency is specified. So you need to delete it as well to ensure that that does not affect your problem, as we have seen in pump as well. So now activate this curve and then enable this curve, and you can see you have required your result and that is okay. And if you go back, The adiabatic efficiency is 83.634%, while the polytropic efficiency is 83.975%. The polytropic method used is this one, and the duty is 468.1 kilowatt, which is required. And what is the final pressure? The pressure is from 100 kPa or 1 bar to 2.553 bar. It means if we come here again in design, delta P is 155.3 kilopascal or 1.553 bar. The pressure ratio is 2.553. obviously it's a single megawatt option, but again we can use multiple options as well if we have been given multiple curves. And just like this one which we have here, we have to again add a curve and activate it to solve our problem. We can also give offset values for head and efficiency if we are specified. If there is no selection or no specification, we will keep it as zero, which means no offset parameter to be included here. Now if we go to this performance tab, in results you can see the adiabatic head is 4790 meter, the polytropic head is 4810 meter, the adiabatic fluid head, polytropic fluid head, power consumed, head factor, exponent and speed. This speed represents the operating speed, and the speed which we have specified in the curve was the reference speed for the compressor. Now going to this compressor rotor power, total rotor power is 468.1 and total fluid power is 468.1, because we have not assumed any frictional loss or any losses in this system. Similarly, the compressor rotor torque is also given over here. So a very detailed information is given for this compressor module as well. Now if we go back to the properties, and again we want to solve the exergy analysis which we have already done in our previous activity for the compressor, where we have selected nitrogen and oxygen in the system, that can also be done over here as well. And you can see the mass exergy values are given. We have to simply calculate as we have specified in our previous problem as well. And if we go to this rating, we can plot the curve as well, and the curve can be plotted in two terms. Number one is head and number two is efficiency. So there are two ways of doing it as well. And if we go to this flow limits, the values are given. We can even plot surge curve as well, but obviously we will do it in some other part of a video, not obviously in today's part. Here inertia is calculated, electric motor power is given, and all the information which is required for the system is calculated over here. So that's how the compressor curve is inserted in Aspen HYSYS module. We have previously learned in Aspen Plus, and now we have learned in Aspen HYSYS. But please make sure that once you are inserting the curves, these active button, or even if you are doing any simulation in Aspen HYSYS, this active button is turned on in the system. Similarly, for the given problem, the units were not same as that of the requirement, like it were in degree centigrade and kilopascal. But if you want to convert it to degree centigrade and bar, then euro SI is the appropriate unit to give you answer. The temperature of degree centigrade, pressure of bar, and obviously flow rate is kg per hour, which was our requirement here in the system. So that's it from this video. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel, Aspen Tech channel. Please click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos.